Hello there, welcome to Ms.RedNebula's Plain Coat Tips, Thememaker's Toolkit Edition. In this video, we'll be talking about how to use Flexicolors for toolkit objects in Planet Coaster. You can have up to 4 Flexicolors per object. Flexicolor maps use the suffix _F1, _F2, _F3, and _F4. You don't have to use all 4, you can have a model with just an F1 map, an F1 and F2, and so on. A flexicolor map is a grayscale image where black is not affected by the color at all, while white is fully affected. You can also use gray for blending, but I'll get to that in a couple minutes. For flexicolor maps to work properly, the areas of the base color, or BC, map that you want to be flexicolor should be very light gray, almost white. The guide recommends about 90% gray, as a completely white base color can cause issues in-game. Parts of your base color map that you don't want affected by flexicolor can just be their normal color. You can also have some different gray tones in the flexicolor parts of your base map just to give it some variation. The first flexicolor map is F1, which will correspond to the first flexicolor slot on the uploader as well as the first flexicolor slot available in-game. To create the flexicolor map for this slot, simply color the area you want to be affected in white. When you upload this object, you can now use the flexicolor defaults at the bottom of the screen. Because this model only has an F1 map at this time, only the first flexicolor default will do anything, the rest will be ignored. In-game, the parts of the model you specified as F1 will now be the default color you selected in the uploader, and of course, can be changed to whatever color you wish. To add a second flexicolor is just as easy. Make a new map with the suffix F2 and color the parts you want affected in white. Now when you upload, you can set a default in the second color slot. And in-game, you now have 2 flexicolor slots to play with. For our third slot, suffix F3 this time, I want to show you something else. If you make a portion of the flexicolor map grayscale, it will blend this flexicolor with whatever's underneath. You can also overlap flexicolors over one another. It's important to note the order. The base color will be applied first, then F1 over the top of that, then F2, F3, and finally F4. Note that our F3 map overlaps our F1 map. Because F3 has some grayscale, the result will be completely F3 in the white areas, but a blend between the two colors wherever the F3 map is gray. Use the third color slot on the uploader to set a default, and here's the resulting game. F4 is the final slot, and we'll apply it in exactly the same way. Make your map, set the default, and then check out the result. Flexicolors are applied over the top of all other maps, so the flexicolor part of any map that would normally be in color, such as base color, specular maps, or emissive maps, would be gray instead. Note that this does not apply to normal maps since their colors have a special purpose that has nothing to do with the final color of your model. When you make the icon for your item, it's best that the colors in your icon match the default colors of your flexicolor object. You can do this by making a special map you only use on your Blender item when you're taking a screenshot, or you can set up your screenshot from within Planet Coaster using white panels for a clean background. One additional note, there's currently a bug with specular maps not playing nice with flexicolors, and your model will just come out white even though the flexicolor options are there. Fortunately, there's a workaround. For now, just throw in an all-white OP map. For some reason, specular plus flexicolor plus opacity works, where just specular plus flexicolor does not. But speaking of opacity, that's actually what we're going to talk about in the next video, making things see-through. And that's it. Feel free to like or comment, and if you want random updates from my Planet Coaster exploits, subscribe! If you enjoy what I do and are interested in supporting the channel, check out my Patreon. In addition to helping me out, you can also get fun perks like sneak peeks, voting on future projects, or being the first to see new videos. A big thank you to my current patrons. That's all for now. Bye!